Hi friends, I am Dr. Hema Kumar from DCE Bangalore. In this video, I am going to give some introduction about science and technology innovation policies made by Government of India. India decided after independence to make science and technology an integral part of its development strategy. The Indian Parliament endorsed a scientific policy resolution as early as in 1958, articulating the vision and aspiration of the nation. Engagement of the common man with science and technology was considered a necessary part of this strategy. The Science and Technology Communication, Popularization and Posterizing of scientific temper among the masses and decision makers have been emphasized again and again through the policy instrument prolonging during 1958 as a scientific policy resolution to make a scientific temper and capacity building, and in 1983 technology policy statement for technological competence and self-reliance, and again in 2003 scientific and technology policy has been introduced to increase the investment in R&D, and fourthly in 2013 science, technology and innovation policy has been introduced for the development of socio-economical development in India. Each document has ample emphasize the importance of science popularization. Government and non-government organizations have played and also still playing a vital role in fostering the scientific spirit in the country. Since our independence in 1947, India has been successful in building a massive ecosystem of science, technology and innovations. And science, technology, innovation ecosystem includes universities, public, private, enterprises and human resources. Today we are enjoying with 993 universities, 39,931 colleges and 10,725 standalone institutions listed on All India Survey on Higher Education web portal. Among 993 universities, 298 universities are having affiliating colleges, 385 universities are privately managed and 394 universities are located in rural area. 16 universities are exclusively meant for the growth of women. 3 in located in Rajasthan, 2 in Tamil Nadu, 1 in Andhra Pradesh, Assam, Bihar, Delhi, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Odisha, Uttarakhand and West Bengal. In addition to those universities, there are 1 central open university, 14 state open university and 1 state private open university, and there are 110 dual mode universities which offers education through distance mode also, and the maximum 13 of them are located in Tamil Nadu. There are 548 general, 142 technical, 63 agriculture and allied, and 58 medical, 23 law, 13 Sanskrit and 9 language universities, and rest 106 universities are of the other categories. Some of the top scientists, technologists and CEOs of the world have been beneficiaries of our science and policy ecosystem. This has been made possible through the implementation of robust policies by central and state government over the years. Our first science policy can be traced back to the year 1958. The policy document was drafted by the government of the India, the then Prime Minister of India, the Jawaharlal Nehru. Scientific Policy Resolution 1958 laid the foundation of strong foundation of scientific enterprise and scientific temper in India. The Jawaharlal Nehru has imagined India to be a welfare state. This resolution was born out of the realization that the creation of welfare state was only possible through investment in science and technology. Science and technology would thus act as an instrument of socio-economic transformation. With an aim to provide a reasonable amount of economic, social, culture, amenities and services to every citizen through industrialization, investment in science and technology was critically as it was reduce the burden on the use of raw materials and capital, would also reduce the gap between India and the developed countries. Thus, the Scientific Policy Resolution 1958 recognized that science and technology were crucial for nation building and national prosperity. The actual purpose of Scientific Policy Resolution 1958 was to cultivate scientific enterprises in pure science research, applied science research and capacity building at a large scale. In order to achieve this goal, Scientific Policy Resolution 1958 recognized that it was essential to develop educational programs to ensure an adequate supply of scientists. Creating a pool of high-quality scientists on a large scale was necessary to fulfill the country's needs, especially in areas such as agriculture and defense. Science Policy Resolution 1958 highlighted that it was important to create a culture and mechanism where creative talents of citizens are recognized and opportunities are found in scientific activities, acquisition, dissemination, and discovery of new knowledge. Science Policy Resolution 1958 was primarily a science policy document. Technology development was given secondary importance, as it was assumed that the technology development could only stream through the study of science and its applications. However, post Science Policy Resolution 1958, large-scale investment in science resulted in the emergence of several scientific organizations and national laboratories. Science Policy Resolution 1958 was able to lay a strong foundation in science and research and development and higher education. As a result, the implementation of Scientific Policy Resolution resulted in many scientific organizations. Among those top were the Defense Research and Development Organization, that is DRDO, in 1958, and Department of Space in 1972, the Department of Electronics in 1971, the Department of Science and Technology in 1971, and Department of Environment in 1980, which plays a major key role even today in development of science and technology in a country. As an overview of Scientific Policy Resolution of 1958 is that the motivation of the designing this Scientific Policy Resolution 1958 was to nourishing scientific enterprises or scientific temper. The science and technology seen as an instrument of socio-economical transformation and nation building. It is a silent features or cultivation of scientific enterprises in pure and applied science, research and capacity building. Opportunities for scientific activities discovery and dissemination of new knowledges. As a result, it's impacted emergence of several scientific organizations and national laboratories in a country. Strong foundation in science, in research and development and higher education has been put in 1958 policy. The second policy came in 1983. In the aftermath of passing scientific policy resolution 1958, India spent the next 3 decades building its scientific enterprises. By the early 1980s, India had developed a strong industrial and agricultural base and also had a large pool of trained human resources. As the technology was increasing, seen to influence lives and bolster societal expectation, the next major policy development, technology policy statement 1983 has made, focusing primarily on meeting people's aspiration through technological development. The primary feature of technology policy statement 1983 was technologically self-reliance through the promotion and development of endogenous technologies. Adoption of endogenous technologies would reduce the vulnerability in critical areas and would help maximize the utilization of local, that is, human and materials resources. The technological policy statement 1983 recognized that there should be an efficient adoption of imported technologies, but not at the cost of national interest. Technology had to be identified and replaced with the technologies that improves the productivity, efficiency, quality and reliability of the product using minimum capital and energy utilization. The fundamental aim was to use technology to provide maximum benefit to all sections of society and especially to improve the conditions of backward and weaker strata. Finally, the technological policy statement 1983 stressed on strengthening the technology base, especially in new sectors at that time. That is, the information, electronics, biotechnology, through an increase in research and development investment and collaboration among governmental organizations, educational institutions and industries. In order to fulfill the mandate of Technological Policy Statement 1983, an implementation committee was set up to draft detailed guidelines for ministries and industries to bolster endogenous technological development. The Technology Development Fund was established to provide the financial assistance to Indian industries. The Technology Policy Statement of 1983 highlighted the need for continuous and systematic prediction of how useful emerging and current technologies are going to be in the future. Technological forecasting and assessment studies, especially in the ministries with a large investment and production values. With this in mind, the Technology Information Forecasting and Assessment Council, TIFAC, was established. However, post-1991 economic liberalization paved the way for the large foreigners' investment in several sectors. Thus, the technological self-reliance and adaptation of endogenous technologies were at the odds with economic policies in several socio-economic sectors where there was a large dependence on foreign investment. The Technological Policy Statement 1983, the main motto was to technological seen to influence lives and bolster societal expectation. Focus on meeting people's aspirations through technological development. The silent features was to maximize the utilization of local resources like human and materials, and strengthening the technological self-reliance in new sectors, information, electronics and biotechnology. As a result, it is impacted to establishment of technological development fund and establishment of technological information forecasting and assessment council. The third policy, science and technology policy 2003, has been came. By the turn of the millennium, India has established a sound infrastructure based in science and technology in terms of institutions and human resources. However, it was acknowledged that there was dramatic change in how science was practiced, how technology was developed, how science and technology interacted, and how they affected society. Science was becoming more multidisciplinary, spanning different sectors and different countries. Thus, it required the development of clusters of institutions and multinational collaboration. High investment in research and development were required even in the area of basic science, basic research. The Science Policy Resolution 1958 and Technology Policy Statement 1983 focused on science and technology respectively and separately. However, the science and technology enterprises were so intertwined that there was a need to think about them together rather than separate elements. With the rapid advancement in information and communication technology and the democratization of internet, exchange of knowledge and information was occurring at a previous unseen rate. Science and technology started having an unprecedented impact on economical growth and social development in a country. The new issues related to cybersecurity ethics, such as privacy consideration and inequity, came to the fore. In order to keep pace with the science and technology to stay competitive in an increasingly globalized world, and to meet our primary goal of equitable and sustainable development, Science and Technology Policy of 2003 was enacted by the Government of India. A significant feature of Science and Technology Policy 2003 was a process to develop mechanism within the ministries and agencies to gather inputs from scientists and technologies, vice versa, planning for the planning and policy making, and a call to invest heavily into the research and development sector with an aim of increasing investment of 2% of GDP of India. Science and Technology Policy 2003 recognized the need to modernize existing infrastructure for science and engineering in academic institutions and set up new funding mechanism for basic research. The policy also called for the development of incentives mechanism to attract scientific and engineers, especially of Indian origin, from abroad to contribute to the Indian science and technological instrument ecosystem. The Science and Technological Policy 2003 was aimed at encouraging research and development and innovation in areas that impact the economy and society, and developing the mechanism to facilitate interaction among various stakeholders within the country. Finally, the Science and Technology Policy 2003 called for cross-pollination of industry and scientific research and the establishment of intellectual rights regimes to protect and incentivize inventors. It also encourages research in management and mitigation of natural hazard. This policy document laid special emphasis on science diplomacy, especially on international science and technological cooperation between developing countries located in global south. Post 2003, there was a significant rise in overall research and development investment, rise in both public as well as private investment. At the end of the 10 years period after the adoption of mandate of science and technological policy 2003, even though our research and development investment did not reach 2% of national GDP as was called by the mandate, it was at the global benchmark figures of 0.7% of GDP. India made a significant jump in publishing ranking. There was also a steady increase in human capacity. We started churning out many more PhD students, more patents were filed, and more startups incubated has been developed as a result of a 2003 science policy. The science and technology policy 2003 motivation was to recognize that the science and technology enterprises in intertwined and interactable. Unpredictably, the impact of growth in information technology and democratization of internet on socio-economical growth and development. Its silent feature was call to invest heavily in research and development. Goal to increase investment in R&D to 2% of national GDP. Modernize the science and technological infrastructure in academic institution. Incentives returns of scientists and engineers trained abroad to contribute to the Indian R&D ecosystem. As a result of 2003, the impacted to significant rise in R&D investment of 0.7% of GDP at the end of 10 years period. Rise in India's publication ranking, and in the world it's standing the third place in publishing the scientific papers. Steady increase in institutional and human capacity. In 2006 onwards, the new IITs, on 2008 onwards. The fourth policy is the Science, Technology and Innovation Policy was established in 2013. The decade of 2010 to 2020 was declared as a decade of innovation by the then Prime Minister Manmohan Singh. It was acknowledged that in order to stay globally competitive, it was necessary to make a transition into a knowledge-based economy. There was a need to synchronize science, technology and innovation to position India among the top five global scientific powers. With this objective, the fourth policy, the Science Technology Innovation Policy 2013, was implemented. As the name suggests, critically new element in this policy document was the term innovation. Promoting a science and technology-led innovation ecosystem in a country and broadly linking science, technology and innovation to a socio-economical priorities were some of the key aspects of Science Technology Innovation Policy of 2013. This policy document was step in the right direction toward building a robust national innovation ecosystem. It paved the way for promoting science and technology-led innovation in the country by attracting private sector contributions into the R&D ecosystem. It laid emphasis on directing scientific discoveries and output of science and technology activities toward developmental priorities in key areas like agriculture, manufacturing, water, health, environment, and infrastructure development. This policy also resulted in India's increased participation in global mega science initiatives such as the Laser Interferometer Gravitational Wave Observatory, LIGO, the Large Hadron Collider, the International Thermonuclear Experimental Reactor, the Square Kilometer Area, among others. However, since we are still within the decade of innovation and in-depth evaluation of this policy, remains to be done to understand its impact in its entries. The Science, Technology and Innovation Policy 2003, the main motto was the 2010 to 20 announced as a decade of innovation. Intend to synchronize science, technology and innovation to transcend to a knowledge-based economy. Aim to position India among top 5 global scientific power. Its silent feature is innovation is the key to build science and technology-led innovation ecosystem, attracting private sectors in research and development, linking scientific technological innovation to socio-economic priorities. As a result, is impacted a step in the right direction toward building a robust national innovation ecosystem. India leadership and participation in global mega science initiatives and Indian scientific policies has been made India to grow from developing country to a developed nations by these 4 policies. If you like this video, you can subscribe our YouTube channel and share this video. You can reach us through Facebook, Telegram link and email ID. Thank you friends, we shall meet in the next video.